Hello, my friend. Today we're going to be talking about something very important, which your school forgot to teach you. Your parents probably don't know about. Your friends probably don't know about. So, where would you have learned this if not from here? Or maybe you've heard about this before in some other video, in some other teacher like myself, some other spiritual medium, some other form of intuition or book that you've read. But this is an important topic which a lot of people don't know, which is why they struggle with life. We're going to talk about the laws of the universe. As you can see in my screen, I have spelt it as universe because one thing I need you to understand is that your universe is not the same as mine. Your mom's universe is not the same as yours. There are about 8 billion universes on this earth because perspective and the way that you see the world around you or perceive the world around you is not the same as the other people around you, okay? So once you are able to understand these laws, you'll be able to create your reality more effectively, which will separate you from other realities and maybe you to make your reality more similar to mine. Or similar to other people who understand the concepts and the laws that I'm about to talk about. Let's move on. So the first two laws we're going to dive into is the law of attraction and vibration. So what is the law of attraction? Like attracts like. Your thoughts and your belief shape your reality. Positive thinking draws positive experiences. Negative thoughts attract negative outcomes. Let me give you an example, because stories are the best way for you to realize that you are actually in control of your reality and the things that happen to you are happening through you, not at you or to you. They're happening through you and for you, right? The best example I can give is in my situation, I had an ex-girlfriend. And how me and this ex-girlfriend of mine met was very synchronistical and very important to understanding the law of attraction. If I was in the mindset where I believed that this girl was too beautiful, she was too fine for me, I would have never approached her, I would have never walked up to her, I would have never said hello. But I'm of the knowledge of these type of universal laws where I know that my thoughts create my reality and how I see myself and what I believe I attract, right? So I had the confidence and the morale to walk up to this person and say hello and ask for her number. And to her, the first time I ever did this, she was surprised and she was like, oh no, because I had walked up to her and I had touched her cheek and I squeezed it and said, wow, you're so pretty. And she was like, oh. And she walked away from me. And I'm single now, though, by the way, but it's just a story for you to understand. And when I did this, the first day I met her, I never collected her number. She rejected me, but I was like, oh, okay. I never attached her rejection to my self-worth or my belief in myself. Right, and long story short, the next time I saw her, she was more pleasant. She had seen me and she waved and she said hi, and I said hi, and I told her, come here, and she came, right? Because I didn't give the energy off into the universe that I was not deserving of a beautiful woman. So, the thoughts and the beliefs that you believe about yourself really shape your outcomes. And really shape what you attract. Because for some of us, the first reaction, and mind you, me and her met at her workplace where she was working, right? Mind you, some people will take that rejection and never show up to that workplace again so that they don't have that awkward moment with her where it's like, oh, she rejected me and I don't want to ever see her again and I have to change my whole city. I have to change my. No. I still showed up to her workplace because it's a social place where people meet up I wasn't going there the second time thinking, oh, I'm going to run into her. I just was without thought, or I had detached myself from the outcome of whether I was going to get her or not as my girlfriend, right? And eventually we got to know each other and we dated for a while. And the only reason why we actually broke up is because I relocated cities, right? So that's a great story for you to understand that your belief and your thoughts about yourself and the situations around you on a daily basis create your reality. And the reason why the second law, which is the law of vibration, is right beside the law of attraction in this image you see on the screen is because they go hand in hand. And what is the law of vibration? Everything vibrates at a specific frequency. Higher frequency vibrations like love, joy, attract similar experiences. Lower vibrations like fear and anger draw negativity. Do you understand? Let me break it down. So the reason why these two laws are attached is because your thoughts and your belief create your attitude and they shape your emotions, how you feel about yourself. Your emotions are directly connected to your thoughts and your beliefs about anything, who you are, your environment, if you're going to succeed. So for instance, let me give you another story. I also own a digital marketing agency as well. And when I first started my digital marketing agency, I was full of fear, but it was part of my self-development journey where I'd read everything I needed to know about the law of attraction and all these different laws and spirituality. I was tapping into getting to know myself more and more and the powers I have as a human being, right? And I needed to get more clients. I wanted to make more sales because I like to create ads. I like to create commercials for people to help grow their businesses, right? So I'm very confident about what I do, and I know I'm very good at what I do, but most times it's always the fear of rejection that keeps me from taking action and actually pursuing things. Fear, like I said, the law of vibration has to do with your emotions. Fear. But I have love for what I do. And the love I have has to outshine that fear, because I actually believe that what I can do is valuable and it will help my clients and it will help grow their businesses and give their businesses more brand awareness and attention, right? So I had to take action. And this story is very important. And if you watch some of my previous videos, I mention it a lot because it's a key indicator of how this thing works. And this is the fastest money I've ever made in my life. I don't like to use the word making money. I believe we cannot make money. The bank makes money. The bank prints money. We take money from other people in exchange for value. You take money from other people in exchange for value. And you attract those people with your thoughts and your beliefs. And you vibrate at a certain emotion which they feel in the way you speak and the way you offer them your value, right? If you don't believe, if you are attached to the outcome, if you are fearful about the outcome, if you're scared of rejection, your client is going to hear that when you pitch them your ideas, when you pitch them your business offer, when you pitch them your value offering. They're going to feel that. It's a vibration. The way you speak, the way you deliver, it will not reflect to them that you believe and love what you do. So I met this lady off WhatsApp. I was on a WhatsApp group filled with entrepreneurs who usually post and advertise their businesses to other entrepreneurs and things like that, just for networking, right? And I saw her and she posted her product with her sauce, and I reached out to her and I said, hello, wow, I really like your sauce. I've never seen anything like it. I would like to sit down with you and tell you what I do, and I really believe that what I do can help scale your business and help it grow, right? And she was like, wow, okay, when are you available? And I said, I'm available Tuesday, 10 a.m. We can meet here in my office. This, 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 that, the details. Boom, Tuesday comes, 10 a.m., we meet. I'm passionate, I'm excited, I believe in what I have to offer, and I tell her everything. Oh, this is what I've seen for your business, this is what other people are doing, this is why I do what I do, and I believe that if I'm able to work with you, I can deliver the best quality, I can provide service that maybe you're not an expert in, that way we can be partners and get your business to another level. And for her, it was a no-brainer. For her, it was a no-brainer. But it's not because of just I'm able to read something online and come together. No, it's because I love what I do. I believe in myself and I believe in what I have to offer. And my thoughts about those things are pure. My intentions are pure. My thoughts are clear. I'm not attached to the outcome. I'm not thinking in a fear-based reality. And this goes for the same story I told you about how I got my girlfriend, right? I wasn't attached to the outcome. My emotions and my desires were, this girl is beautiful. I would like to get to know her and hopefully one day she'll become my girlfriend. And I shared that emotion with her, but then, wow, you're so beautiful. I'd like to get to know you. And the first day she was like, oh, I don't know you. And she was a little bit scared or terrified by my actions. Then the next time she was more comfortable just because of I didn't react in a angry way. I did not react. I did not take her rejection or her actions the wrong way. I just took it for what it was and I moved on with my life and my day. And I was able to attract a beautiful woman in my life because of my vibration and my energy was pure, right? So these are laws that you need to learn that will govern your life from now on, which means you need to be more careful about the thoughts that you think. You need to break down the beliefs that you have about yourself and the world around you. Plus, you need to make sure you're always in high frequency emotions like love, faith, belief, and stay away from low vibrational emotions like fear, anger, scarcity, greed, you know, things like that. Now let's move on. This is another important thing you need to understand, the law of cause and effect, the karmic cycle. Every action you take sets the karmic cycle wheel in motion. Your intentions and deeds ripple through the universe. Consequence, the universe responds to your actions. Positive actions bring positive results. Negative actions lead to challenges. And one thing I need you to understand is the definitions that you also, the way you define things. You need to define things. Not everything, like a rejection, is negative. A rejection is not negative. Everything, like, everything you define, everything is a definition. You need to be careful about your definitions. Nothing is intrinsically good or bad. You define things as good or bad, and you define things as positive or negative. But the only thing that is true is how you feel, which is your emotions, the emotions you attach to those definitions. Like, for instance, let me give you a great example, which is also the example of the girlfriend, right? Like I said, most people, when you get rejected by a woman, you think all hope is lost. And you see some men making that mistake of calling her out of her name. You call her a bitch. You call her different things. You start to insult the woman because she rejected you. Right? Because you see that as a negative situation. Oh, she rejected me. So it's a negative situation. But me, I saw that. Oh, I didn't even attach a positive or a negative meaning to it. I didn't. But I for sure didn't give it a negative meaning. I didn't say, oh, I must be ugly. I must be this. Oh, she doesn't like me. I did not attach any negative. I must have attached positive things now that I think about it. Oh, maybe she's shy. Oh, maybe she's shy. Maybe she's not ready. Oh, maybe it's because she's at work. I attached positive meanings to the reason why she was not ready to talk to me in that moment, right? And I need you to understand that most things, that happen to you, always assume that it's positive. Always assume that it's positive. Every time something happens to you, you take action and you expect, detach from the outcome, first of all. But always, anytime the outcome appears, always assume that it's positive. Always. Never assume that, oh, I got rejected. Like, if somebody rejects you for a business proposal, say, okay, maybe the universe is protecting me because this contract would have stressed me out in many ways. This contract would have not let me discover that I can charge more. This contract, you know, always assume that the reason why this didn't work out is for a positive reason. Something not working out does not automatically mean that it is negative. You need to understand that fully, and that's all I'll say on that. As above, so below. The law of correspondence. Your inner world shapes your personal experiences. Your thoughts and emotions create your immediate reality. That's what we've been talking about with the law of attraction and the law of vibration. But one thing you need to understand is that the universe is internal. It is mental. The reason why I'm fit, it's not just because of I'm externally strong, but it means I am internally strong. It means that I have the discipline and the focus to be able to go to the gym 6 times a week and increase my weights and bear through the pain afterwards of the soreness, because I have a goal that I want to achieve, because I keep that positive mindset. It's a reflection of my internal, which is why people respect fit people. People respect wealthy people, because it's not just about the wealth. It's not just about the body. It's about, it's those things are a reflection of the internal. Your inner world shapes your personal experiences. Your inner world shapes your personal experiences. Your thoughts and emotions create your immediate reality. Most people think they cannot be fit. That's why they are not fit. It doesn't start from outside in. It starts from inside out. Understand that everything is mental. The universe mirrors these patterns on a grand scale. Cosmic events reflect human experiences. Understanding this connection allows you to influence both the inner and outer realities. I like to say this way. The outside reality is really not real. Everything is inside. Nothing, like, look around your room right now. Look around wherever you are watching this video. Everything that is in front of you or around you started in somebody's mind. I didn't create this pen. Somebody did. And some church, as you can see, this is a pen from a church. You can see that, right? Some church bought this pen, designed it, and put their logo on it. It started from somebody's mind. My mouse, my computer, my camera, my light, it all started. There's nothing you can point to. The house around me, the chair I'm sitting on, the extension cord, everything around me is created, and it started from a thought. Somebody wanted to start an extension cord business, and they started it and they put it on Amazon. Whether it's 10 years ago, 5 years ago, and I decided to pick up Amazon and order it. I don't know when they decided to make that decision to start making extension cords. I don't know who invented extension cords. Let's take it that far. Everything around you started from a thought. I'm going to be making a video on turn thoughts to things. So look out for that video, first of all. Let's move on. Embracing life's rhythms and polarities. So let's go into the law of rhythm. Life moves in cycles. Embrace the natural flows of ups and downs. Challenges are temporary. And I want you to understand this too. Like I said, there's no positive or negative. There is positive and negative, and positive literally means high vibrations and high frequency, and negative means low vibrations and low frequency, but there's no good or bad. Some people think when there's no, like for instance, let me give this example. People pray that God, I want you to give me, I want to have money, I want to start making more money, I want to feel comfortable, I want to have a live a better life that is fulfilling for me. And they lose their job or they get fired and they're confused, like, what happened, God? I prayed to you. I prayed for you. I prayed for you to do this for me, and I prayed for you to make me richer, but you're making me poorer. You know what they've just done there? They've defined to themselves that without the job, it means poverty. That without having a job, it means you're poor. You have embedded that definition into your head that without a job, I am poor. But the universe and God is trying to show you that, okay, you want money? I picked you out from your job. You can't, your job has capped you at a certain salary. So in order for you to actually make more money, I have removed you from that situation. So you will be free to make as much money as you want. But no, people don't realize that. They label it as a negative thing when they prayed for a positive thing. Because truly, all your prayers are answered. Ask and it shall be given. Seek and you shall find. Knock and it shall be opened unto you. Law of polarity. Everything has its opposites. Light and dark, love and fear, define each other, embrace duality. But like I said, most things, the law of polarity is simple. It's like the yin yang, right? Positive and negative. Positive and negative vibration. The world, even the world that we live in right now, the universe, your universe, it's either you're in a positive universe or you're in a negative universe. And the only indicator of that is your vibration, your frequency. What frequency are you vibrating at? And that will reflect, oh, the world is chaotic. I promise you, there are some spiritual people out here that think the world is going to end. I promise you. I promise you that people that like in 2012, for instance, I was 12 years old in 2012, and there were people that convinced me that the world was going to end, and I was terrified that, yo, the world is actually going to end. I was terrified. I experienced it like, yo, this world is about to end, and boom, nothing happened. So there are people operating in that lower vibration at the moment of fear. There are people that are pushing the narrative of fear on others on a constant repetitive basis. And you need to tap out of that. You need to block that out of your reality and focus more on a positive and high frequency. Remember, polarities, low, high, up, down, left, right, positive or negative. Most of them, that's what it means. Law of transmutation. Energy is always transforming. Positive thoughts can change negative experiences. Shift your energy deliberately. Powerful. And so can negative thoughts change positive experiences. For instance, there are many situations where I go out with certain people and I'm on my way to an event with somebody else, for instance, and I'm seeing it that, wow, they're going to be, wow, this event is about to be lit. There are going to be girls, there's going to be food, there's going to be drinks, we're about to have a good time. And some people are like, oh, the other person you're with can be like, oh, I don't look good enough. What if they don't like me? Oh, I'm not in the mood. Their thoughts are just filled with things that are negative. And when we both arrive at that party, who do you think is going to have a positive experience? Me or them? Me, of course. And I want to even give this as an example. There are so many times I've gone to a party alone or the club alone by myself, no friends, nobody. And I get there because of I know how to create my reality. I get to the party and I'm able to manifest people that give me free drinks, offer me food, party with me, we dance with strangers that I just literally met. I just created them. I have the best time of my life with people that I'm never going to see again. But I bet you some people don't really believe that is possible. They believe that, oh, if I go to the club alone, it's going to be boring. I'm just going to be in a corner. And all it took was me believing like, oh, I'm going out. I look good. I smell good. I dress good. Who wouldn't want to be friends with me? And I go up to somebody and I say, hey, yo, what's up? Is this party bumping? I'm like, yeah, bro. It's bumping right now. Oh, yeah, okay. Yo, bro, let me just hang out with you guys, man. I really don't know anybody. Oh, shit. It's always sure. And guess what? If somebody tells me, oh, nah, we can't hang out, I will find another person. It's easy to make friends here. We'll get to the law of oneness soon. So you understand that everybody is literally you. It's a reflection. The world is a mirror. The world mirrors your vibration. It mirrors your thoughts. It mirrors your actions. If you go into the party head down, frown on your face, say hi to nobody, guess what? That's the reflection you're going to get back. This party is boring. This party is dead. Nobody likes me. Of course, because you're vibrating so low, you can't even see the nice people all around you, right? The law of oneness and divine order. Universal connection. The law of unity teaches that we all are interconnected. There is no true separation between individuals or nature. Cosmic purpose. The law of divine order suggests everything happens for a reason. Trust in the flow of life. Like I said, we are all one. There's no true separation between individuals or nature. We are all consciousness in a body, but we are all filled with different thoughts and beliefs, which create a unique universe for each and every person. But there are thoughts and beliefs that you can predict in other people that you know, oh, if I respect myself and I respect others, then we can definitely have a good time together. I don't think that's difficult to understand, that if I respect myself and I'm nice and I'm polite and I'm kind in my words, I think people will be nice, polite, and kind to me. Not everyone, of course, but I think 90% of people will be, right? Everything happens for a reason. Like I said, if you get rejected, you started a business, you let's say you start a clothing brand and you have a shirt and you go up to someone and say, oh, this is my shirt. Look, for instance, this is an Emporio Armani shirt, $200. I was gifted this shirt, for instance, right? But Emporio Armani is a brand. They're selling black t-shirts for $200. The same black t-shirt that any brand could sell. If they gave up when somebody rejected, oh, you're just selling black t-shirts. Why do you think you can sell it for $200? And they quit. Oh, you're right. I'm going to quit my business. You're right. I'm going to quit. I'm going to stop selling t-shirts for the price I want to sell them because you're right. You're right. And they quit and they stop. This shirt would have never gotten to me for free. I never paid for this. Somebody paid for this for me. Matter of fact, it was that girlfriend that I told you about in the beginning. Just saying. But let's go to 3, harmony. Recognizing our oneness promotes compassion and harmony. What affects one affects all. I think that's self-explanatory. And like I said, if you go up to people with compassion, kindness, politely, I think, obviously, if you're not asking for something absurd, you're just asking to hang out. You're just asking to sit down in their booth. You're just asking to get to know them. You're just asking for them to check out your website, check out your business, check out what you have to offer politely. I don't think there's any harm in that. And guess what? It might just reflect in your favor. And if it's not meant to be, then that person is not on your vibration or frequency. So it's in your favor. Again. The law of free will and abundance. The law of free will empowers you to make decisions. You are the author of your life story. Your choices and consequences align your decisions with universal laws for positive outcomes. Your choices have consequences. Align your decisions with universal laws for positive outcomes. The law of free will is pretty simple. You can watch this video and not to believe a single thing I said, and move on to your life and keep being negative and keep doubting yourself and keep being less confident and keep thinking you're not worthy and keep thinking anything that is on the lower frequency that is keeping you there. And you have the free will to do that. Nobody's going to come and change your mind, because at the end of the day, nobody can see your thoughts. Nobody can see your frequency. Nobody can feel your frequency or see your thoughts or your beliefs. So that's the free will. That's the protection of your free will. Nobody can hear your thoughts. Nobody can feel your vibration. So you're free in choosing whatever you choose to feel. You can feel whatever way. Oh, Boogie's lying to me. Cool. If I'm lying to you, cool. Think whatever you want to think and feel whatever you want to feel. But those are the laws, like I told you. The law of abundance. The law of abundance teaches that there are unlimited resources The law of abundance teaches that unlimited resources are available. Adopt an abundance mindset. Like I said, there's unlimited money. There's unlimited resources. There's unlimited people. So even if a girl rejects you, for instance, there are unlimited girls. You cannot have 10,000 girlfriends at once, but you might get rejected by 5 and the 6th one might be your girlfriend. Or guess what? You might talk to the first one and she'll become your girlfriend. But there's abundance. You might talk to one client, get rejected, talk to the second client, get rejected. Talk to 100 clients, get rejected. But guess what? There's still more clients. You might start one business, fail, start another business, fail again, start a third business, fail again. But guess what? There's abundant business ideas. You might be the first one to create a brand new business idea or a brand new product that solves people's problems. So don't be so. Be compassionate with yourself. Be compassionate with yourself and realize that nothing is truly negative. You are the deciding factor that this outcome is negative because you saw it that way. But if you chose to see that outcome, oh, this business failed. Okay, maybe because my next business is actually what was meant to take me out of there, right? Take me out the hood. Maybe it's not this business that's meant to take me out the hood. Maybe it's my next business. But some people fail the first time and go back to their 9-to-5 that they hate. Oh, business, all these people are liars. Boogie's a liar. He told me to start a business and I failed. So he's a liar and I have to work this job I hate for the rest of my life. But you can see it as, oh, okay. Now I have this idea for a new business because I've learned so much from this business failing. I now know what I don't like and what I should be doing, right? Negative emotion is an indicator of what you do not want. So every time something feels negative, it just means that I don't want this. I want something else. I don't want this. I want something else. That's simply all it means. So I hope that you apply these laws, but remember, you have the free will to apply these laws. Apply these laws by practicing positive thinking, acting with kindness and compassion to yourself and others, but most importantly to yourself. Because remember, you have the free will to think what you think and believe what you believe and feel what you feel, which is your vibration. You have the free will to do that, but give yourself kindness and compassion with what you think and what you feel. Recognize the recognize the interconnectedness of all things. Please do that. You're not alone in this planet. Everybody is literally you, an empty vessel that came here and downloaded a lot of programs from the world and the history around them. Make conscious choices. Stop making unconscious choices, like stop operating in the wrong paradigm. I'm going to make a video on that, so subscribe. And when you subscribe, you be able to receive the notifications. Turn on the notifications so that you receive videos that I make, which are important to change your life and your destiny. That is my purpose. That is the only reason why I'm doing what I'm doing, to help you discover who you are and the potential you have to elevate and live a life that is exciting and purposeful to you, not me, to you. You have the free will. Cultivate high vibrational emotions. The idea that, oh, you have to be sad sometimes is crap. You can be happy 100% of the time because you have the free will to do that. So cultivate being on high vibrations all the time. Don't let anybody fool you that it's a bad thing to want to be excited your whole life. Embrace life's natural rhythm. Like I said, there are times where you'll be tested and there are ups and downs, but remember, those down moments doesn't really mean down. You are the deciding factor. You can choose that this thing I'm going through right now is for a reason, and maybe it is definitely for my best interest. Always assume the best. Trust in divine timing, right? That's the same thing. Trust that this moment of unpleasant is a path to the pleasant. It's always a path to the pleasant. Adopt an abundance mindset. Abundance. Nothing will ever finish. You will not run out. There's always another. There's always another. There's always another. If you lose a friend, you can get another friend like this. If you lose a girlfriend, you can get another girlfriend. But that's not the mindset I want to keep. Cherish the people in your life. If you have a good thing, cherish it for sure. But if it doesn't work out, it's not the end of the world. If your business doesn't work out, there's another business you can start. There are other ideas that will come to your head. There is abundant money in the world. If you don't have money right now, you can get money. You can take money. You can't print and make money, but you can take and collect money. Okay? So, I really hope, and I know, I don't even hope, I know if anybody watches this video, it will definitely, oh my gosh, my face is hiding behind my thing, but it will definitely change your life if you watch this video to the end, and I hope you do. Thank you.